Hello and welcome to today's video on changing an application folder or hard drive's icon. I'm in Finder here and looking at my hard drives, and I want to change my data drive to something a bit more interesting. Note this tip can be done with applications, folders, any document you want. The method is exactly the same. What I'm going to do is I'm going to replace my data drive icon with this of R2D2. Now this trick can be done on applications, folders, any document you want. It really doesn't matter. The method is exactly the same. Now this is my data drive currently with a hard drive icon, but I'm going to use this picture of R2D2 I found on this internet. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up the get info pane using Command I or File Get Info. Now this is the icon we're going to change in the top left corner. First step is to get the image we want into our clipboard. I've opened it up in preview, and using Command A and Command C I can copy it to the clipboard. You can get rid of preview. It doesn't matter how you copy it to the clipboard, you just need to get it there. So you can copy it off, for example, a web page, a document, anyhow, it doesn't really matter. So if we select this icon and hit Command V or edit to paste, notice how we paste the icon onto the hard drive. Now in Finder and within the desktop, the icon has changed. And if we use quick look on it, we can see that the icon has changed to R2D2. It really is that quick and that simple. So what do we do if we want to change it back to the hard drive icon or the original document icon? Well, we don't have to copy or paste anything, we don't have to find the original. All we do is we open the Get Info pane again, select the icon and hit Delete or Backspace. Notice how the icon has now returned to its original icon. Finder's smart enough to realise what the original icon is and find it and put it back. It doesn't take long at all to customise your applications, your folders, your hard drive icons. All you need is a good source of images. If you have enjoyed this video, please subscribe as there are plenty more Mac tricks and tips videos coming.